the study of the interaction between sun, building and surrounding environment, it is important to understand what are the quantities involved on hourly, daily or yearly basis. In general, the calculation of the solar radiation can be divided into instantaneous and cumulative values. When calculating the solar radiation incident on a surface, one can refer to two parameters, irradiance and irradiation. Irradiance is the instantaneous solar power incident on the surface. It varies instant by instant and is measured in watt per square meter. Irradiation is the cumulative energy collected from the surface in a given period, day, months, or year, and is measured in kilowatt hour per square meter. A given oriented and inclined surface on the Earth receives global solar radiation, which is the sum of three components: direct radiation, diffuse radiation, reflected radiation from the ground or the surrounding surfaces. The direct radiation, which comes straight from the sun, is influenced by the spatial disposition of the surface. More perpendicularly the rays strike it, the higher the amount of collected radiation. Also, diffuse radiation depends on the spatial disposition of the surface, and more precisely on how it sees the sky dome. Since we can assume that the diffuse component comes from all directions of atmosphere, the greater the portion of the sky viewed from the surface, the greater the collected diffuse radiation. The reflected radiation depends on the mutual spatial disposition of the absorbing and the reflective surface, on the incident radiation onto the reflecting surface, and on the albedo coefficient of the reflecting surface. Solar radiation incident on a surface at a given time of the year depends on the climate, the spatial arrangement of the surface and the solar path. For example, in the chart you can see the solar irradiance trend in Nairobi during the spring equinox on surfaces differently inclined and oriented: horizontal, vertical south, vertical north, vertical east, vertical west, south facing 20 degrees tilted. Solar energy incident on a given surface at a given time and in a given site can be evaluated with this formula, where IT is the total instantaneous irradiance incident on the considered surface expressed in watt per square meter. IB is the direct irradiance incident on the horizontal plane expressed in watt per square meter. RB represents the ratio between the direct solar irradiance on the horizontal and that on the considered surface. ID is the diffuse irradiance on the horizontal plane expressed in watt per square meter. FS and FC are respectively the view factors of the sky and of the surrounding ground. Rho is the albedo coefficient. I is the total irradiance incident on the horizontal plane and is the sum of the direct and diffuse irradiance IB and ID. RB depends on the mutual position of the sun and the irradiated surface, hence on the specific location, day and hour, as well as on the orientation and the inclination of the surface. Its value is calculated then as a function of the following angles: solar altitude, beta, solar azimuth, alpha, surface azimuth, gamma, tilt angle of the surface, psi, latitude, phi, solar declination, delta, hour angle, omega. FS is the view factor of the sky dome from the considered surface. FC represents the view factor of the surrounding ground from which the reflected radiation reaches the considered surface. Both factors depend on the tilt angle of the surface, psi. The formulas shown until now allow to calculate the instantaneous values of solar radiation, namely the values of irradiance, the radiative power. For the purpose of building applications, it is, however, more interesting to calculate the cumulative values, that is the irradiation values, such as the incident energy on a collecting surface during a day. With this aim, you can calculate the integral of the curve joining the instantaneous values of irradiance. Otherwise, by applying a simplified method, it is possible to obtain daily values of irradiation from the hourly values of irradiance. In this case, you have to calculate the irradiance values hour by hour, and assuming that they remain constant for the next hour, you can switch from watt to watt hours. As you can see in the graph, underestimation in the morning hours are offset by afternoon overestimations. The sum of the hourly values provides the daily total. Solar radiation data can be taken from databases or from radiation squares. Each radiation square shows the mean monthly hourly solar irradiance on a horizontal surface, subdivided into its direct IB and diffuse ID components. In order to better display the magnitude of solar radiation, the cells in the chart have different backgrounds depending on the value of the total irradiance. In conclusion, the formulas and the calculation methods shown in this lesson enable to calculate the irradiance values on any given surface for every hour of the monthly average day. Input data are taken from weather file or database and can be used to calculate the irradiation, that is, the incident energy, daily by summing the hourly values, monthly by multiplying by the number of days of the month, and yearly by summing the monthly values.